Yeah, like made a gurgle noise, and then off the backside. I mean, just all came out.
Oh, because they had like moved him, and yeah. So it all just came.
Yeah, just all came flowing out. And Leah dropped him, ran to the bathroom.
Dropped him on
started,
the ground?
No, oh, all back on the bed. It was her and another person holding up. Started throwing up. And it was the bathroom. So she comes out like 5 minutes later. Her face is just streaming with tears, and she's got all teary eyed. And she's like, oh my God, I just. And so.
You people are supposed to be nervous.
This is the first time we've ever been encountered with something like that, you know, though? I mean, like.
They can't stand the poop.
So you wouldn't be able to take it either.
I wouldn't. Oh, I can't.
I promise I could. I can do poop. I can do whatever.
I can do anything else.
No, the only time I've ever passed out in my whole entire life, besides when I was pregnant, I passed out twice. I always passed out in the bathroom. Like, I'd get weird and dizzy, and then, like, I'd have to fall to the ground, and then, like, I'd just lay there, like, unconscious for a minute and stuff. But, the one time I shadowed a gynecologist, and
you what?
A shadow, you know, like, I went to watch them, a gynecologist in, like, the 11th grade. And I went, and, you know, like, we did lots of baby stuff, and then we found somebody that had herpes, which was kind of like, wow, you know? She was like, I think I have, she came in and she thought she had, like, a sex plane, like she had torn something.
Her vagina.
And, well, they come in.
Her snap.
He comes, he, so he's looking down there, he takes me outside. He takes me outside and he goes, that woman has herpes. And he said, and we have to tell her, you know, that it was her husband that, like, forever that gave it to her. So he had to have been screwing around, like, the hardest news to break ever, right? Like, my husband's been, like, she finds out all in one day that she has herpes and her husband's been cheating on her.
That's a heck of a day.
Yeah, so, that's like, nice. That goes first, and I'm all cool with that. I got to look at herpes, and that was fun. And then, we have to go watch him manually turn a baby. What is it called?
Oh yeah.
Like he takes his palms and he like tries to push the baby who was breached around. Well, it didn't work. And this woman was in like the most pain I've ever seen a woman in my life. It probably was worse than childbirth. And she was like crying because, you know, he's trying to turn it on the outside, completely hurting her. That didn't work. And so I watched that. And then the next thing I get to see is this 90-year-old lady who had to have a hysterectomy, right?
Why?
Probably something wrong, cancer, or cyst, something, you know. She had to have a hysterectomy. She's maybe not that, maybe like 70s, 80s, I don't know. And so she comes in and she said, I've been having problems with my incision, you know. He lifts up her shirt from here to here. And like, you know, she's a, you know how old people are, their stomachs are kind of big, you know. And it's like this stomach like this, and then this incision from here to here oozing. Like I've never seen a wound, like completely and totally infected. So he's like, oh man, you know, it's infected. And this poor old lady, and it, I mean, it's gross. It's red all over, it's got pus all over. And so he takes it and he squeezes the top and the bottom, pus running out like a waterfall. And I was like, oh my God, okay, I can take it, I can take it. And then he sticks, you know, like a Q-tip, but they're long, he's sticking it in there. Inside her, like a bunch of them, you know, I'm like cleaning out all the pus, and then about that time I went, and I was like, I gotta go outside for a minute, and I walked outside, shut the door, fell on the floor, and all the nurses in the office are like, are you okay? But you should have seen it, can you imagine somebody sticking, like this much, like inside you, and like in and out, and like pus, and like, I was just like, freaking out. No, I don't know, I guess not. She was just like, kind of like, ooh. I think it was already hurting so bad that like, it didn't really matter what he was doing.
I get a little weird when I'm like cleaning my belly button then. I'm just like, okay, look.
No, you know. Should have seen, it was like the nastiest wound. It was like, you might as well have been gangrene or something. It was like,
yeah. Oh my gosh, my friend Kelsey's patient, she goes to a hospital a lot. Her friend called her because she didn't go clinically, so she's like, oh my gosh, your patient has gangrene and you can smell it all the way in the hot hallway. And she's on restraints because she tries to bite people.
She tries to bite people.
Kelsey goes, I'm going to have a hell of a day tomorrow.
She could be, what if she like tried to bite herself? Like, got gangrene bite everywhere.
Oh. She bites people. That's funny.
She's on restraints. Yeah. And she's got gangrene. What does gangrene smell like?
Oh,
death
no.
Warmed up.
I don't want to know. Well, maybe you should go get a whiff. That way you know if somebody ever has it.
That way you'll know.
I'm pretty sure I can tell.
Yeah, that way you'll know. You at least you'll know.
I know, that's a good one. That's why we didn't use the brown for that.
She already got some.
In fact, I can get
okay, I gotta get.
I think I want
I want a, I want a piece of orange.
Yeah, would you give me one? I'll man the front desk.
This is us just hanging out at work today.
I like it. I'd rather large. Stories about
poop and herpes and vaginas.
Jeez, you freak me out when you touch your computer.
We'll see you later. Bye.